Discover your New Orleans. Start exploring at followyournola.com.
I think that the spaces in the city are so special because of the light that we get. We have high ceilings. We have incredible architecture. We have incredible architectural detailing inside of these homes. And so I think that all those factors combined and the history of it all give our spaces and interiors sort of a timeless quality no matter what you really put inside of them. We always have a heavily sort of French influenced sort of background with antiques and things. There's just so much of that here. And it's very interesting to see the way that people try to make those things more modern and current. So I think we'll always have a very traditional base, but I think it's exciting to see people trying to do different things with those pieces. I really get inspired a lot when I'm running in the morning through the Garden District. And, you know, every house has something new to see at different times of the day. And I'm like, oh, I would never have thought to put that color with that color and that color on a house. And I keep that. And then, you know, maybe 6 months later, I'm like, oh, wait, I can really put that rusty red with that strange green and try to make a room scheme out of it, and it's going to work. You know, I'm really excited about the full expansion and completion of the World War II Museum, which is just a few blocks away from here. I think it's really, really changing that neighborhood. I mean, the Warehouse District has always been a great place to live, and I guess, you know, there's some wonderful restaurants, but I feel like it's bringing a whole new level to that part of town. And I'm also excited to see that down in the Bywater, there have been some incredible mixed-use buildings that have been repurposed into loft living, restaurants, and that's really, I think, great.